We'll stand together.
Okay. Look into what is it? Camera. So are you old like a grape or blazing like a raisin?
Yeah, but does that mean anything? They're just gonna be like, what?
Does that mean? Does that like? How would you answer that question?
Just choose one. I don't know.
Yeah.
Welcome back to another edition of Pause Play. I am the Zach Monson, and we are here today with Canada's very own Franklin Electric. How are you guys doing?
Good, man. Good. How are you?
Very good. You want to introduce yourself? Tell us what you do in the band.
I'm John, the singer and the piano player and trumpet player of the band, and I'm sitting here with my buddy.
I'm Liam. I'm the drummer and vocalist of the band.
So, you know, right off the bat, Franklin Electric, where does this name stem from?
It's not really a very deep story, but we were just sitting around one night and a guy was like, yeah, my buddy got fired from the Franklin Electric company and we didn't have a band name. And I was kind of like, well, we need a band name. That would be kind of cool. It's got a ring to it.
And were there other names in the bucket of names you were going through?
Let me think. I think I had some ridiculous names. Like, my name's John. So at one point I was like, let's call it John Mac, like a Mack truck. But then I was like, nah, that'd be horrible. Then it was called like Finger Grapes.
Finger Grapes.
Yeah.
I think you should change it back to Finger Grapes. You like that? I think that's a solid
one. If we ever change our name, that'll be it.
Franklin Electric out, Finger Grapes definitely in. So, you know, what is the music that you guys started to listen to when you were younger? You know, that wasn't just your parents' music, that wasn't just your siblings' music, that you started to like as yourselves?
I think we're pretty well-rounded. Like, I went to school, so I listened to a lot of jazz when I was younger. But still stayed, I had, you know, pop roots, a lot of rock music as well. Rap music, kind of a bit of everything. And I think I could speak for everyone in the group when I say that we listen to like a lot of different styles of music in general. So it's kind of a nice mix. Yeah.
Yeah, it's all over the place. I'd say me too, jazz. I studied trumpet and stuff like that. But I also loved the hip hop. I had my hip hop phase where I was against rebelling and stuff.
Should we expect hip hop on the next album then?
No, but secretly there's some underlying influences in certain like percussion elements and rhythms and stuff that we're trying to incorporate for the next record. Okay. So it's fun, yeah.
And how'd you guys come together as a band?
Honestly, it's been quite the journey. The band has been kind of shape-shifting and evolving and transforming. And then finally we found four guys that are just kind of like down and we all get along and there's a very positive chemistry and the show is just getting better every show. So I think we're going to stay as these four guys for a little while. And
yeah, it's working, I think. Yeah, you don't need a fifth. The new album is, you know, This Is How We Let You Down. You know, tell me about writing the album. What's the process like for you guys, writing a song, bringing it to the studio, and finishing it?
So, well, the first album was kind of, it was written a lot by me, I'll admit, and which was hard on me because I felt very alone doing it. I was in a basement in Brossard with my little pre-production studio. And a lot of it was just based around like self-reflection and moods that really could make me feel something strong and in hopes it would relate to the people that would listen to the music. And then I'd bring in the guys and we'd rehearse the songs and go over some arrangements and figure out the parts and stuff. But we really took the first record as like a almost sort of like a really well done demo. It was like we tracked live off the floor and it was kind of on purpose. It's kind of the charm for the album. But now the process is kind of changing. Everybody's giving more input and we're learning about each other and discovering how to work together. Because it's not always easy, but you give and take and in the right positive mentality, you know, everybody's got a good idea. And it's just kind of like bouncing ideas off each other and working together has been really a challenge and a new discovery and a fun discovery for us these days. So,
do you guys have a favorite song off the album? I know it's always a hard question because I know I'm sure they all hold true to you.
What's your favorite song?
My favorite song is probably This Is How I Let You Down because it's the most depressing song and I've been very depressed at times in my life. But I hope that doesn't continue. But
I'll wish you the same. I hope you're not depressed for very long, yeah?
I like Unsatisfied is probably my favorite one.
And why is that?
The opposite of John, actually. It's like the most uplifting song, I would say. Except for that lyric, Unsatisfied. Yeah.
So, you know, what's the major difference that you guys find now being signed to Indica versus being an independent band?
The help.
Yeah, a lot more connections to the industry.
Yeah, well, no, honestly, there's so many positive things that come out of that. First of all, they're a great team, and they're very...
Great label.
Yeah, like, they're very respective of what you do as an art, very humble. It's not this big office, big record, like a record company office that's like all about money. It's very, very just down to earth. And like we started, basically me and my friend Henry, who's been managing the band since the beginning, since our best friend passed away, he kind of joined the team. And we would do stuff on our own, like, and I would cold call agents and try to get things going just to jumpstart the machine. And I always said, like, what I can do in five circles, they can get done in a half a circle because of their years of experience. So at a certain point, it was like, okay, we need help. And they came to the rescue.
Good. So we asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question. So here it is.
We're from Hey Rosetta, and our question to you is, when you find yourself at a karaoke bar late at night, what is your go-to? What is your go-to jam?
From Hey Rosetta.
Beat It by Michael Jackson.
Oh, that's a good one.
Benny and the Jets.
Benny and the Jets?
Elton
that
John.
Is a classic karaoke song.
Yeah, it's the
yeah
best.
That's a classic one. So, you know, you guys were heavily involved with, you know, David Suzuki's Blue Dot Tour, you know, a campaign to promote
yeah
every person's right for, you know, fresh water, healthy food, and a clean environment. How did you guys get involved, and what can people do to kind of bring the world into a place where that exists?
Well, I think it was just to really, really raise the awareness of what's going down with, like, certain things in Canada. And on top of it, it wasn't even just to raise awareness for people. It was also to get into the governments and the city halls and try to create regulations and stuff like that, which David is really trying to attack as well. So it's even politically on the rise, too. So I think everybody should just maybe be a bit more aware of things like that.
Okay. So being a Canadian band, what are some other Canadian bands that you guys are into that people might not know?
I'm going to say Diamond Bones. It's actually my girlfriend's band, and
that's the best plug you could ever do.
Yeah, and she's
they're
actually doing great. It's good music. It's like pop music, and great singer, and yeah, I'm really into them. Good band.
Yeah, and we'll obviously have to plug our good buddy Johnny Griffin, who's starting a new band right now, John Jacob Majesty.
I heard about them a few days ago, actually. Yeah,
he's been really honing his craft and starting off and doing great, and
killer.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming by. You can hear Franklin Electric on Stingray Music's Adult Alternative and Canadian Indie Channels. Thanks so much for coming. You going to play some songs for us?
Sure, yeah. We'll set up and do a little thing.
A little jamaroo.
Yeah.
See you next time, guys. Bye.
And I got feelings to show. And I know this much, there's still lots to learn. To learn to let go. Oh, the health it he's drinking again. It's like breathing.
Bootmickey's into the stadium, talked about every record we ever loved, and by the time we were driving back home, we figured we should probably start writing tunes together.
Yeah, 24 hours.